Hi, I'm Jean-Marc Prieur, a program manager on the Microsoft Identity team. In this video, I'm going to show you the code related to authentication in a web application that lets users sign in with Azure Active Directory using their work or school account or their Microsoft personal account. Signing in users is a prerequisite to many scenarios such as having the web app access with the user's consent their data using the Microsoft Graph. I'm assuming here that you are familiar with the notion of Azure Active Directory tenant and understand .NET Core 2 web applications. So what's our agenda? After a quick intro to set the context, I'm going to explain why you'd want to enable sign-in in your web application. Then I'll quickly provide insight into what's happening during the sign-in process. Then we'll walk through which part of the code does the magic. And finally, I'll share some resources to get to the next steps, including the sample used in this video and other samples, which will help you go further, for instance, to call the Microsoft Graph. So what is relatively new this year is that you can use the Azure AD V2 endpoint, which lets you sign in users with either work or school accounts or Microsoft personal accounts, formerly named live accounts. And from then, you can call your own web APIs. Sign-in users leverages ASP.NET Core components which implement industry standards such as OpenID Connect. So why would you want to enable sign-in in a web application? I've shown a few scenarios here. For example, you might be developing a line of business application hosted in Azure, but still would want only the users in your organization to access the application. So this protects your application. Or you might want to offer users a customized experience. Or finally, signing in users is a preliminary step to calling a web API in the name of the user. So you really need to understand this first part, this part first. So what happens when a user signs in? It turns out that the web application delegates to Azure Active Directory the task of signing in the user. And for that to happen, the application needs to be registered with Azure Active Directory, and the code of the application must be configured to match this registration. We'll see that in detail in the demo. I won't show you here in this video how you can create the ASP.NET Core 2 application from scratch and register it, but for that you would have to follow the sample mentioned in the resource file at the end of the video. And now let's see the code in details. Here I'm in Visual Studio. I've opened the code for the application and I'm going to run it to show what happens, the sign-in. So that's pretty obvious. Everybody has seen that, but I think I will attract your attention to a few points. By the way, what you saw just behind was the configuration of the application. We'll come back to that. So when the application starts, what happens is you are forced to sign in. I'm going to sign in with this account. That's done, and if I put that full page, you have seen a dance with Azure Active Directory, and I see hello and my identity, so I'm recognized. And then there is a button, which is a sign out button, but which can be replaced by the sign in button, and I can express which identity I will sign off with, and then that is transformed into a sign in button. So what code does the magic? When the application starts, what happens is you get to a controller, which is the home controller. And in the home controller, you have this attribute, the authorize attribute, which will force the authentication. And then how does it force the authentication? But as any program, this ASP.NET Core application starts with a program, so you know that's not always the case. And then this program will call a method in a class named startup. And this startup class has two interesting sections. One, which is the fact of enabling authentication, use authentication. The second is about configuring the services. And here for a web app, we say that we want to use first OpenID Connect, which I mentioned previously, to do the authentication. And we want to keep the identity, in fact, in a cookie. And This is configured. I mentioned the fact that we were configuring things. This is configured. This line tells us that the configuration is in a section of a config file named Azure AD, and that that will populate some options. And the options are really here, Azure AD options. So what is this, and what is this config file? So to understand that a bit better, I'm going to split my screen between two parts. One which shows the IDE, and the second which shows the configuration for the web application. And this configuration shows you that the application has an application ID, and the application ID is exactly that what you have here. That's this the same UID. That also tells you where we are going to authenticate. What is the Azure Active Directory? This is this thing. And where will Azure Active Directory call us back? And it will call us back to this signing OIDC URL, which you need to also explain in the redirect URL. And by the way, if you are familiar with Azure ASP.NET Core, you know that the URL where you sign in is specified in the launch setting, and you find it here as well. So that's for the configuration. And let's go back to what happened in this class where, and I will be full screen again, where we read these options from the configuration file, and then we configure things. So we configure the client ID for this application, for this web application. The authority is what we will accept tokens from, and when you do the ASP.NET core application, you would have a specific tenant, which I haven't filled here because I'm accepting actually identities from any tenant, any work school or Microsoft personal accounts, hence this common V2 thing. And to do that, by the way, I won't let the framework validate. I will say, okay, I'm happy with any of those coming. Of course, you could enforce some validation here. So the last thing I would like to show you is the UI. Where do these buttons come from? So these buttons come from the shared folder. In the layout, which is including in every page, you include, ASP.NET includes a login partial, and login partial is this. And what this tells us is that depending on whether the user is authenticated or not, we will show, so if the user is or she authenticated, we'll show a sign out button so that the user can sign out, and otherwise we'll show a sign in button. And if the user is authenticated, we'll show also the name, the email address in that case, and the email address is extracted from the identity. And in terms of identity, we mentioned this notion of claims, which are evidence about the user as provided by the STS, by the security, let's say Azure Active Directory. And in that case, we extract the preferred username by casting to a claims identity and then extracting this value. That code had to be changed also for V2 compared to what you would have generated for a V1 application, because ASP.NET Core 2.0 provide a solution for V1 application. So that's it for the demo. I hope you found it useful. We've explored the most important part of the code related to authentication in an Azure AD V2 web application. The slide behind me recaps the files added to enable authentication in a web app and the ones which are changed. See the colors. To conclude, here are some resources you can follow to find more information. I encourage you to go through the sample yourself and learn how to recreate it. I've also included samples which will take you from this point to calling the Microsoft Graph, a link to our documentation, and a link on how to get help, ask questions, and post suggestions. Thanks for watching!